Hey everyone, this is going out to the PlayStation blog. We're here in Austin, Texas, where Lightbox Interactive is headquartered. I know I've gotten a lot of email and tweets and all kinds of stuff about people wanting to know about our next game, and you guys all kind of knew we were doing Starhawk anyways, but man, I was just on lockdown. I couldn't really say anything, so it's just like, oh, I'm so glad we could talk about it. Basically, it's the same crazy fast, fun gameplay that all you guys love from Warhawk.
Charge him! Charge him! What? Take his... Knife him!
But yet, you can control the battlefield. You can build bunkers where you want. You can build walls where you want and towers and all of these structures. And it really changes up the way the game plays.
Oh my God, it's like watching Dancing with the Stars!
Oh, sorry. Hey!
Hey, Dylan. What's going on, man?
Yeah. So what we've got going on is we've got a LAN party going on here at the Alamo Draft House. We've got an observer cam in Starhawk that's connected and broadcasting up here on the screen. And we're watching all these guys play, and it's just, it's riveting. It's good television.
Good television. Entertaining. That's exactly what Starhawk is. It's community, it's multiplayer, it's action, it's bam, 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 right?
No, no!
So yeah, we're here. We showed single player, which is awesome. Our hero character, Emmett Graves, showed build and battle, showed our advanced AI technology.
Lynn!
This is great. You want to grab this?
Destroy that bunker!
No, no, no! Don't destroy the bunker!
1, 2, 3.
I love shooters, don't get me wrong, I absolutely love them, I play them way more than I should, but they feel like, from a compositional perspective, we're retreading the same territory over and over again. Warhawk didn't have single player, so we're putting a single player in Starhawk. It really gave us an opportunity to try something new.
Cool.
Tried to come up with a different convention, and I mean, we referenced all kinds of different games, from all kinds of third-person shooters to even some real-time strategy games to, hell, even like Plants vs. Zombies.
You guys are trying to tell a story here. Talk about the story.
Well, the story, it was interesting. We started the development of our story by creating the pillars that were going to facilitate gameplay. So we knew we needed an item in the universe that two teams could fight for, that could be a special element that the hero could have, and that could also be the currency for our building. And we started from there. There was actually some hesitation, like, oh, is this going to be too much like a real-time strategy game, and you know, all this management? And obviously, as you can see, it's not like that at all. There certainly are some RTS light elements, but the fact of the matter is, the building in our game is as punchy and as fast and as visceral as it is to pull the trigger of your rifle. The thing I'm happiest about is I actually get to talk to our fans about it now, because I think they all think I was just an ass, like, because I couldn't respond and I had, you know, like so much duct tape over my mouth, I couldn't really talk about it. So it's like, now I can finally talk about it. We've been working on this game that, I mean, it's for our fans.
Yeah.
And so it's going to be great to be able to talk about it.